In the previous topic, we learned how to create an empty InfoBase. In this lesson, we'll understand what to do when we already have an InfoBase and we need to apply it in our platform. There are actually three ways to add an InfoBase in 1C Enterprise. The first way is from the launch window. If you need to open an existing InfoBase, you need this file that stores all the information about your InfoBase with 1CD data type. To add an existing InfoBase, we need to click the Add button on the 1C Enterprise launch screen and choose the Add InfoBase option. After that, we have to input the name for our InfoBase and select the location of our main file. Then on the final page, we just have to click Finish. So now we can actually access the same InfoBase using two options from the InfoBase list. The second way is to add and dump an InfoBase from Designer mode. And in Designer mode, we can create a compressed copy of any active InfoBase. A .dt file is a kind of an archive that stores all the InfoBases. Using this copy, we can restore our old base from the .dt file into the new InfoBase. We can actually restore our old InfoBase into any other base. So be careful as you may delete the active InfoBase by restoring the old one. Finally, the third way lets us add not the InfoBase, but the configuration. So let's discuss the difference between them. The InfoBase contains both information created by the professional developer in Designer mode, as well as all the information inputted by the user in 1C Enterprise mode. However, the configuration only contains the information created by the professional developer in Designer mode. The configuration will be empty of user data. Now that we've understood the difference between the configuration and the InfoBase, we can save and load the configuration from the file. We need to click Configuration and then Save Configuration to File. And that's how we get a compressed configuration file of .cf data type. Now this way may help in a situation where we only need the configuration without the user data, or in a situation where we want to save the user data but make major changes in the configuration itself. So restoring the configuration doesn't delete the user data. It only updates the InfoBase configuration. In the same way, we can load the configuration from the file without changing the user data by clicking on the corresponding option. And now that you've installed the 1C Enterprise Platform training version, you can create new apps and also restore the existing apps. In the following topics, we'll discuss the components contained in the apps and their settings.